Day two. Darkness. Silence. Suddenly, a movement. A shuffle. A thought. And then, a question.
Can we please have some light?
The light flips on, and Entiel is stuck in a series of strings, quite like a web.
Sorry, Enti.
Arachne helps him out of the web.
How's your day going, Arachne?
I'm not sure. It's only the second one.
This all food chain stuff?
Yeah.
Going that good.
It's exhausting. I feel like I'm doing the work of three departments, and every time I think that I've almost cracked it, some species I didn't think of pops up from the bottom of a file folder, and I have to shuffle the whole thing around again. What do you have going on today?
More digestive systems, mating patterns, boring stuff.
At least you're on schedule.
How was your first night?
It was weird. I mean, we had all known darkness before. At least, I think it was darkness as much as darkness can exist without light. But it was familiar. But now that we have light, it changes the darkness.
Right? I mean, we were all there as God created light, and now I can't imagine a world without it.
It is going to be a long first week.
Where's Terriel?
They're at the plant department.
Oh, those assholes.
More species to add to the food chain.
You know, I still think you should.
We have talked about this.
Just one. Sneak it in there.
I can't. Every species has to go through Terriel and then to Ariel before it comes to me. And even then, once I've placed it in the food chain and you draw up the schematics, it all has to go back through to the...
I am familiar with our suppressive corporate structure.
We are angels, Entiel. We have a very strict hierarchy that has been around since the dawn of creation.
That was yesterday.
It is about being part of a carefully organized structure. We are here to execute the design of the higher-ups, not provide our own visions for creatures that are, frankly, quite disturbing.
They're not disturbing. They're cute.
Even if I did sneak one in, Terriel would spot it from a mile away. They don't exactly look like mammals.
And humans do.
They are a special case. You know that. Terriel doesn't want them any more than we do.
What was even the point of making them mammals? We have nothing to do with their actual design.
It's because you know what got the axe.
No.
Uh-huh. Remember we had to completely incorporate monkeys and apes on the fly?
That was why.
That was why. They still don't really fit into the food chain, and I am mad about it.
You know what they could eat?
Stop. It's not happening.
Watch. I'm going to swap two species at random in the food chain here and see if Terriel notices.
Wades into the web of strings and pulls a card.
This is a mongoose. And now instead of being prey to...
He pulls another card.
The cobra is now prey to the mongoose.
He puts the cards in the other's position.
Now watch them not notice.
Why can't you just let this go?
Every species I assist Terriel with, I just find two or three more ideas of my own welling up that I have to write down. And I have so many in my notebook now, one of them has to be good enough. We're creating the world right now. There's never been a project like this before, and there never will be again. Is it selfish that I want to put my tiniest personal stamp on it?
You and I are not the ones creating the world.
Are you really content doing grunt work for the archangels?
You are trailing into blasphemy, and at this point, you are making me uncomfortable.
God forbid.
That's exactly right. They do forbid it.
If you could design anything and put it into creation, no questions asked, what would you put in?
Oh, no.
This is strictly hypothetical.
Not when you're the one asking it.
I wanna know. I can't be the only one with an idea they're passionate about.
You have millions of ideas you're passionate about.
And you don't have even one?
Well, I suppose that if I did create something, it would be furry. I really love that fur we created for the mammals. And it would live in a home of its own, something it created. I would want it to be creative. I would want that if, and I would want it to have a decent appetite.
It sounds adorable.
It is.
What does it look like?
I have no idea.
Terriel enters. Entiel and Arachne scramble back to their tasks. They hand a thick stack of folders to Arachne.
Ugh, back from the dickwad department.
What's all this?
New plants that need to be worked into the food chain.
This is immense.
Tomorrow is their project deadline, so these are all of their last minute designs. How is the food chain, by the way?
I'm trying to make it work, but I am still hitting a lot of snags.
Ariel inspects the board.
Why are mongoose eating cobras and not the other way around?
Oh, they are. Really?
Are you sure it's not mongoose?
We can't allow for careless mistakes, especially when the food chain still eludes balancing. There are real resources being wasted here. Very soon we are going to have this thing called time. And when we get time, we are not allowed to waste that either. Do you understand?
Yes, I will fix it right away. There will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Amen.
Don't worry. It's not you. Marina and Empyrean are driving me up a wall. They keep fighting over who gets to take on the whale project, and I can't get a word in edgewise. Plus, Ariel wants more species from our department, which reminds me, Entiel, I need at least a dozen more mammals fleshed out for today's meeting.
More mammals?
Apparently God can't get enough of them. They saw cats and now they want more.
Well.
Enti?
I have plenty of ideas that aren't mammals.
That's not what I'm asking for.
Please at least bring up the idea with Ariel.
The earth has no need for bugs.
They're called insects? What about these? I call them ants. They live in huge groups called colonies and gather food for the queen, who lays all the eggs. And
one tiny bug laid all the eggs for the entire species. You're insane.
Oh, that poor queen.
Okay. What about the praying mantis? It's holy, always praying. And it can catch prey in its sharp tibia with lightning fast reflexes. And when they mate, the female eats the male whole. Sometimes
Are you done?
What about ticks? They suck blood from other animals and transmit disease. These need a way to get around, just like we all do.
Let me see.
Teal excitedly hands Terriel his sketchbook.
Do you have any mammals in here?
Not in that book.
Terriel throws the book in the trash.
No, bugs, insects, whatever. Can you sketch up that augmented horse I talked with you about?
Fine.
He sits down and sketches. Arachne has been flipping through the stacks of plant species.
Did you happen to talk to the plant guys about the flowering plants?
What is his problem, Arachne?
He wants... Look, I'm not sure. He won't let this insect thing go.
But they have those huge eyes and so many limbs.
Snakes have a lot of limbs, too.
Don't get me started. Serpents were set from on high as a required species for us to design. They were not my idea. The legs of a snake are so ungodly. I hope they fix them in an update.
Here, I kind of phoned it in, but it should work.
See, was that so hard? I'll present this and see what direction we want to take the mammals in before all beasts are created. I'll tell you how it goes when I get back.
Ariel exits.
Well, that wasn't so bad.
I don't understand why they don't at least mention my insect ideas to Ariel.
They told you they don't want to insult them.
She takes the book out of the trash and brings it back to Entiel.
I should have led with bees.
Bees?
Bumblebees. I mean, look at them.
I'd really rather not. Make it fatter.
What?
I love it. And I want it to have a big butt.
But if I make it fatter, the wings won't be able to lift it off the ground.
Enki, listen to me.
Oh, I'm listening.
I have seen the light. And not just because it was created yesterday. I have seen all the beauty of creation in that single little yellow fat fuzzball.
I'm glad you like it.
You need to make Ariel see this, these things.
Oh, yeah, after I fatten them.
Well, after you fatten the butt.
The butt, yeah. How can I barge into the meeting? We are angels, like you said. We have structure, hierarchies. It's one thing to plead to Terriel, but to crash the meeting? Besides, I have no idea what it actually does.
Well, how does it live?
They live in hives of hundreds gathering food for the queen who lays all the eggs.
Again? With the queen? Why do you love that structure?
But I don't know what it collects for food. I was thinking maybe uranium? And then the hives could be nuclear powered.
Gee, I love you, but that is a terrible idea. I have a better one.
You do?
I was flipping through the new plant species from those horrid horticulturalists, and a ton of them reproducing these things. They reproduce using these things called flowers.
They're beautiful.
They are actually very nice, but look specifically at the way it reproduces.
Arachne, you genius.
You are going to get that bumblebee into creation or else there will be a second war of heaven. I would go to hell for this fat little fucker. Now get to it.
Entiel runs out.
Okay, peace and quiet. Now let me look at this food chain. So the snake eats, right, wrong, what? Okay, it goes apex, predator, down. So eagle eats the snake, which eats fox, eats the rabbit. Oh boy.
She gazes at her work.
I'm just gonna start over. I'm gonna start over. So if I go bottom up, then we start with milkweed. No. Oak tree. Squirrel. Oh, shit.
Blackout. Terriel sits at a conference table with Marina and Empyrean. Marina presents as female in curvy blues. Empyrean presents as a big question mark. Ariel enters in a suit with the faces of a lion, ox, human, and eagle. The three rise as they do.
Sit.
They all sit.
We are to start this meeting by sharing what has transpired today in creation. We then reaffirm our upcoming plans to ensure we carry out their will. We then hear your separate progress reports.
I have a question.
We are not to take questions. First order of business. Today, God successfully parted the waters and created the firmament in which the earth will reside. We have received confirmation that God has seen it is good. We settled on a spherical arc of approximately 88% nitrogen, 21% oxygen, 1% argon, and 0.04% carbon dioxide with traces of other elements.
I was really hoping for more oxygen.
There was too much fire. The Lord saw that it was bad.
You would do well not to question their will.
We have a sample of the atmosphere here.
Invigorating.
Comforting.
The next day is when the seas will part to reveal dry earth, and from it will grow all manner of grasses and herbs and trees yielding fruit.
I'm sorry, is that a change to the previous plan? My understanding was that a stream of water was to rise up, to cover the earth, to cover the ground.
Yes, change is the very nature of creation.
Keep up!
The day after that shall the light be partitioned into the sun, moon, and stars, and be set into the firmament. And the day still after is the fifth day, on which the beasts of the air, sea, and earth are to come into existence. The sixth day shall be the creation of the humans, and the seventh day shall be the creation of Dumans, the favored race destined to destroy the humans. Empyrean, we now hear your progress.
The fowl of the sky are golden. Feathers touching a feeling, and they soar, living always in the clouds. Birds! Oh, birds! I need this.
Mountain chickadee.
And I am so grateful.
That is beautiful.
Marina.
Things at the Beast of the Sea Department have been smooth sailing. We're really on to something with this whole coral reef idea. I think you're really going to love. But before I get to that, we finally have a new apex predator. It's called a shark. They're exactly like those dolphins that we pitched, except less horny and less yuppy.
We like it already. Terriel?
The beasts of the earth are right on schedule. We are officially devoting our resources into the mammal project. In fact, we have some sketches we would like to run by you.
You may proceed.
Well, first, if you liked horses...
I don't care for horses.
Then you'll love unicorns.
That is merely a horse with a horn.
That is certainly how it appears.
I would love to put wings on that.
That's exactly what you said about the horse.
Looks like somebody phoned that in.
We do not like it. We require something we know we will like. Marina.
So I am very aware that we haven't decided on who gets the whale project. I know it's a bit of a taboo, but my team just had a breakthrough with this. And I could not live with myself if I didn't run it past you all. It's called a narwhal.
We love it. Narwhals get into creation.
But all she did was add a horn to a whale.
Yes.
With all due respect, that's exactly what I did to the horse.
Stop talking about horses.
Then shall we talk about whales? This narwhal is uncomfortably close to the whale.
We didn't agree on who gets whales yet.
It was my idea originally.
Excuse me, I submitted the first sketch.
You took my design and swapped out legs for fins.
You can't prove that.
It still has hip bones.
Actually, now that we know what the sky is, could we make a whale fly through it?
No.
Pity.
What do you want for whales?
I want turtles.
No.
Fine, then we both get turtles, but both whales and dolphins are mammals.
I get frogs.
Amphibious.
Deal.
Shake on it. Entiel enters.
Entiel, what are you doing here?
Who enters our meeting uninvited?
They burst up from the table and rush Entiel.
Flowers.
Excuse us.
Flowers, great Archangel Ariel, they have pollen.
What about flowers has so prompted you to interrupt our meeting and forgo all manner of custom and order, small one? Terriel, is this not one of yours?
Not for long.
Please, I would not have gone through with this course of action if I thought I had any other options.
This was no option either.
Terriel, please.
Go.
Terry, you're not going to say anything to him?
Would you? If one of your subordinates barged in here without notice.
I'd say something.
That's not how I remember you.
Why is the green one here?
He's here to make a fool of me.
He'll collect pollen!
Of course.
Did you not hear Ariel?
What collects pollen?
Bees.
Bees?
Bumblebees. They are a creature I want to propose. They are small, fat, fuzzy, yellow animals that live together in hives. They collect the nectar of flowers, which helps them pollinate. Right now, flowers are supposed to pollinate solely through the wind. They'll never take off that way. But with bees, we can get flowers to spread like crazy. With bees, we can fill the world with that beauty.
I apologize for all of this.
Let us see this bumblebee.
TL presents the bee.
That is inspired.
What do they do with the nectar?
They use it to make a food called honey. It's sweet, nutritious, and even medicinal. I think humans and even doomans might like it. So... yeah.
I apologize, Ariel. I have been very clear with Entiel that he is not to propose any of his insect ideas.
It's in.
What?
The bumblebee will be included in creation.
Thank you. Thank God.
Goodbye.
Oh, right. Thank you. I will see myself out.
Mm. Entiel, while you're on that.
Yes. Terriel?
When you get back to your desk, why don't you pack up your stuff?
What?
You're fired.
But my design was included in creation. And I have so many more ideas.
Congrats, but I can't trust you. I was very clear with what I expected of you, and you did not fulfill that. We're angels, Entiel. We follow orders. I want your desk clear and you out of here by the end of my meeting.
Entiel looks around the room.
Goodbye.
And thank you again for the bumblebee.
Entiel exits.
Ariel, do you need help managing your department? We're willing to take on alligators if your team is feeling a little swamped.
I can handle things just fine.
Are you sure? You never seem to take my advice on managing your own department when you got promoted.
You don't need him, Terry? Terbear?
Yes, I'm sure, and no, I don't. I don't need you preaching to me like I was created yesterday.
Perhaps Marina should share some of her managerial tips with you, Terry.
And where is Empyrean?
Empyrean has exited. Terriel's office, Arachne and Entiel.
I mean, I knew Terry was pretty no-nonsense, but I didn't think they would actually fire you on the spot.
I probably should have prepared for this.
Still, it's pretty amazing, isn't it? Your bees will be included in creation.
I think that's the worst part. If the bee was shot down and then I was fired, it would have made sense. But it wasn't. Ariel approved it and then moved on like I was nothing. They didn't make any move to stop Terriel. I've never felt smaller.
We are small compared to archangels.
It's just, they get to make whatever they want. Terriel, Marina, and Empyrean have all designed hundreds of thousands of species for creation. I have to sacrifice my livelihood to get one of my species in there, and when it gets picked up, they move on. Like it doesn't matter.
Entiel, I really screwed up the food chain.
Is it because of the botanical bastards?
I wish. I mean, it started there, but then I shifted some stuff around to compensate for the general lack of biotic potential. So then I had to move even more things around. And then I realized something. It's worse than we thought. There is a pretty huge discrepancy between the plants and the herbivores and the carnivores. And I misplaced a decimal or seven. And so anyway, most species are going to die before to start dying out in a month or so.
How many is most?
I don't know. A lot. All of them.
Oh, can't you just adjust the ratio?
I tried about a million different combinations, and even with bees bringing up the plant biodiversity, most of the birds and snakes and rodents and amphibians and reptiles just don't make it.
Well, I'm sorry I can't help you.
We need you, Enti. A creation is going smoothly, but when it gets to our turn on day five, we are all going to get cast into hell.
Not me. I've been let go.
I don't want to tell Terriel. I really don't.
You're going to have to.
Can't you tell them? You're already fired. What are they going to do? Cast you out of heaven and throw you into the pit?
I wish you luck, Arachne. I guess I'll go get a temp job as a guardian angel.
Oh, you don't want to do that? Oh, watch over a human for their whole lifetime? I heard a rumor that humans are going to poop every single day. You are too talented for that.
What else is there for me to do? The creation is the biggest job market right now, and I just screwed that up.
Empyrean enters.
Psst. Hey. Hell, it's me. I'm Empyrean.
Hello, Empyrean. I just saw you.
Ew. Is this really Tear Bear's office?
Tear Bear? Oh, I'm using that.
Oh, depressing. You guys are supposed to be creative in here?
Not really. Terriel doesn't like free thought.
No wonder all their animals all look the same.
They really all look the same?
Well, they all have four legs and come in either fur or scales. Dogs, cats, geckos, sheep, foxes, lizards, squirrels, and... ugh. Especially horses. They all look the same to me.
You should tell them that. God knows I've tried.
Ech. Not here to talk to Tear Bear. I'm here to talk to you.
Me?
No.
Oh,
sorry. My name is Empyrean.
Arachne, I'm an ecosystems engineer. I'm a big fan of your work.
My God, I love my work too. Birds, feathers, heavenly, talons, colors, displays. They mate in the sky. Migration, freedom.
I'm sorry. You wanted to talk to me? I'm trying to get out of here before Terriel gets back.
Work for me.
I'm sorry?
I've seen the next phase of flying beasts. Birds have been a study. Variations on a theme. And alas, I see my inspiration slowing. But bees. Bees are the future. Fuzzy and fat. Perhaps also smooth and svelte. Stinging. Buzzing. Do you have other works?
Yes. I do. Yes. I have way more. This is a ladybug. She's red with black spots and hides wings under her elytra. She's a sign of good luck. And, this is a cockroach, which can survive no matter how many times you fumigate your apartment.
Wait, what is that?
Oh, I call it a caterpillar.
Is so inspired. The segments, the grotesque mandibles, the... What are those?
Oh, I call them antenna.
I want you to make these for me.
But they don't fly.
My friend, anything can fly if you put wings on it. Come with me to my studio. We will make these beasts soar. What do you call them?
Insects.
Insects. Divine. Let us go.
Z exits, pulling Entiel along with Sir.
Hi. I'll just fix the entire ecosystem while you're off doodling bugs.
Enter Terriel.
Hey, Terror Bear.
What did you call me?
Terry. What I always call you.
So I take it Entiel told you what happened before he left.
Yeah. What a bummer. Totally. Yeah.
I want you to be aware that while I do care about you as your supervisor, I do not have any margin for disobedience or error as we approach day 5. If someone fails to perform the basic role I hired them for, I have no choice but to relieve them of that role. It's nothing personal. Do you understand?
Understood.
So where are we at with the food chain?
I totally fixed it. These animals will be eating so much. They'll be eating plants. They will certainly be eating each other. Just cleaving tendons from the bones with their claws and gnashing their teeth on raw, bloody flesh, rendering their prey into a pulpy mess of matted fur and bone. No weak links in this food chain. So strong.
Glad to hear it. If you need me, I'll be in my office. I've just had a great new idea. You know horses?
Yeah, the furry thing with 4 legs?
Exactly the one. I'm gonna make something like that, except in stripes.
Wow, that sure sounds like a mammal. You get to that while I go through the task that Entiel left me. He had so much work that I can take care of now that the food chain is totally fixed.
Thank you, Arachne. That's a self-starter. You're doing a fantastic job. I love working with angels I can trust.
They go into their office. Arachne signs the cross.
Hi, God. It's me, Arachne. I know that you don't like direct calls. I maybe probably should have gone through Metatron, but you know, I just need to ask. What the fuck do I do? Like, Terriel believes in me. The world is counting on me. And now my best friend was just fired and moved to another department. Please give me some guidance. Where do I go from here? Oh,
God. You and your silent treatment. If you do this with the humans, they're going to have a hard time believing in you. Dad? Hello? All the animals are going to die, and I don't have a solution. Okay, now you're just being a jerk. Like, it was funny, but I'm really in a pickle here, boss. Do you want me to pray harder to get your attention? I'm not gonna sing. I didn't make the first cut at Heavenly Choir auditions.
She gets up and begins to dance around.
Is this what you want? You want me to dance like a monkey? Guess what? Monkeys are gonna be some of the first to go. God, help me.
She falls into her web of strings.
If I had the capacity to feel pain, I bet that would have hurt. What did I land on? Oh, the bee. So cute, I could just eat it up. What eats bees? They don't have a predator right now. I mean, they could. They're small. How would a predator catch them? They're so small. You'd need a net or a web. Eureka! And oh, and then that could eat that. Oh, could be eaten by them. And you see? Was that so hard, God?
Day 3. Empyrean studio. A blank space. Empyrean sits. Entiel enters.
You're tense.
I just walked in.
Do it again.
So, what do you want to do?
No. No. Again.
So, yesterday.
Again. Again.
But I didn't say anything.
Then.
I can't do this all day.
You can't?
No. You have a meeting later to present more beasts. My beasts. And you said I have to make more flying insects than I already have. I made thousands more than I already had yesterday, and I'm supposed to make more? We've exhausted bees. I have hornets and wasps and yellow jackets. We went into beetles, ladybugs, jewel bugs, stags, horn beetles, then flies, dragonflies, damselflies, mayflies, earwigs, locusts, grasshoppers. We've gone through almost all of my sketches. I don't know what else there is. You've exhausted me.
Is it enough?
I don't know. You're in charge.
I am not in charge of you. Is it enough? Are you done?
Yes. No. I just don't have any ideas left.
Then find them. You've explored all of your old ideas. Congratulations.
Are you saying I'm done with my old ideas?
Are you done?
No, we never figured out caterpillars.
Where did the caterpillar come from?
I don't really know.
How did the caterpillar come to you?
I think it was an early draft of snakes. Hence why Shedzel, Terriel didn't like that it was constantly growing, so they took the project from there. But I held on to the original sketch, and before I knew it, I was doodling a new caterpillar on the regular. sometimes multiple at the same time. I would play with color, then shape. I'd give them toxic spikes or put antenna on the butt. I even made one clear as glass with bright marbled insides. But I could never figure out what to do with it once it got too big. And eventually I started drafting up ants and bees, and I forgot the caterpillar.
So, are you done with it?
I guess.
Oh, that's too bad. I really like the caterpillar.
But I don't want to abandon it.
Then you're not done.
But I'm stuck with it.
Do you want it to exist?
Yes.
And that is enough.
Not if I can't figure out how to make it work.
How will you make it work?
I don't know. That's what I'm saying.
Will you make it work?
I would hope so.
Oh, angels do not have the luxury of hope. We have set it aside for the human race.
Then I will find a way to improve the caterpillar design.
Improve or needlessly criticize? Do you think it's faulty merely because Terriel didn't like it?
What are you trying to get at?
I'm not getting at anything. In fact, I am getting at nothing.
You don't even know what you're trying to teach me?
It's very kind of you to think I have answers.
Then what was the thought of the point at thought exercise?
What was the point? As if it's over.
It's not over.
Nothing is. Better.
I'm very confused.
I prefer it to tense.
What is the goal for today?
Again.
So, caterpillars.
Wing?
I couldn't get wings on them.
Tragic.
You were there.
I still am. You didn't need to do that.
Yes, I did.
I love you so much.
How do you find the inspiration for birds?
I don't know.
You weren't joking about not having the answers.
By what you may hear, I'm only ever serious.
You're such an accomplished artist, and you don't know where your inspiration comes from?
Isn't it wonderful? The birds come to me from nothing. Something arises on the slightest breeze. On a whim, that breeze picks up into a sudden gale. My mind blurs and burns as hurricanes of thought construct it. A bird trapped in the wreckage of my mind. Sometimes I have to dig deep into the rubble and ash and preen away the dust and ruffle the feathers. Other times, the bird flits right up to my little hands, and I carry this beautiful bird into reality until one day it flies out into the sky. I never know when my ideas will arrive, and I never know when they will be finished and fly away.
Just like that.
Empyrean simply shrugs, then gets up, feels around, and creates a hummingbird.
Where are the winds blowing for you?
Oh, it's beautiful.
She is... a bird. Wow. Colors. Beating. Sweet. Sweet nectar.
I have it.
Beauty flows through us from ash to sky.
The caterpillar has always gotten bigger and bigger. I've just needed to give it a purpose.
Which is the very bedrock of creation.
It doesn't end there.
Creation is the harbinger of change, of metamorphosis.
It will go into rest, hiding itself as a rock or a piece of bark.
Hit from the rubble.
And it will reemerge as a moth with wings in all different styles. And if I slim the shape, change the wings, a butterfly.
Entiel, are you done?
Not at all.
I must to the meeting now. Come present these when you're done.
As Entiel sketches into a reverie, Empyrean exits. Continuous with the previous scene, Empyrean arrives at the conference table. Terriel, Marina, and Ariel wait for Zer.
You are late, Empyrean.
Oh, does time exist now? Wasn't aware.
You would do well to lose the attitude. God is patient. God is kind. We are neither.
I have an angel on my team designing a completely original line of flying beasts. He got me. But you won't be disappointed when he comes to present.
You have an employee?
I thought you flew solo.
I have chosen to bring someone under my wings.
Why is he to present? That is your job. We shall not allow him to enter.
Yes, you will.
You dare insult us?
Perhaps I do. What of it?
You are to be on time. And forewarn us of any guests you intend to bring into our meetings.
I can do that.
Now to business. As you all know, it is the third day of creation. The seas have parted to reveal dry earth, and plant life is growing to cover the planet. However, God has yet to see that this is good, as reports show problems with the plant's compatibility with the soil. We will be troubleshooting how our contributions may be able to address the soil problems. We have a sample here.
Sorry, we parted the seas for this?
Are you kidding? It's beautiful, firm, loamy.
It's dirt.
How could plants not thrive in this?
On the whole, the soil does not maintain moisture long enough for the plants to thrive.
Oh, so it needs water.
Adding water packs the soil too densely and the roots suffocate. It needs air as well. Terriel.
Yes?
What creatures do you have that could improve the quality of the soil?
Please don't present, like, a striped horse or something.
What? A horse with stripes? Don't be ridiculous.
Terriel shuffles papers under their folder.
What do you propose, Terriel?
Most mammals do produce manure.
Your plan is poop?
That poop is biodegradable and reintroduces nutrients to the soil.
And how does it get mixed into the dirt?
Some animals love to dig.
So they'll dig up all the plants.
I may need to come back with a solution later.
We need a solution today. Creation cannot be postponed. It is their will.
I can re-explore burying animals.
They are all too big. Nutrients and moisture must be distributed through the root systems without destroying them.
Why isn't this the plant guy's problem? They design plants that don't do well in soil.
Have you seen plants? The angels that designed them might be the most foul fanatics of foliage, but plants themselves are perfect.
Can we make the soil more nutrient-rich to begin with?
The plants will merely leach out more nutrients more quickly. It would not be sustainable.
I have an idea.
You do?
New employee. He specializes in small creatures.
He'll probably have a better idea than whatever rut Terriel is digging themselves into.
Oh, will you stop? I don't see you offering any solutions.
Why don't we just keep everything ocean? Give humans and humans fins and gills. Done.
Empyrean, bring in this new employee.
Entiel enters.
Are you kidding me?
Entiel, sweetie, we can't hear you.
Hi. I'm Entiel, as you probably remember. I work for Empyrean now.
Please, you work with me.
Is this some sort of joke, Empyrean? You show up late, backtalk Ariel, and now you invite an angel I fired in front of everyone literally yesterday.
Oh, Care Bear. He's like the cockroach. You can't get rid of him. You'd be able to recognize that if you didn't have blinders on, like the horse that rode you last night.
Yikes! And you thought I didn't like you.
Enough! Even if Z is right, we do dislike horses. But little one.
Yes?
We did enjoy your bumblebee the other day. What do you have to propose today?
I would like to present the moth, a creature that celebrates metamorphosis. It starts life as a tiny little caterpillar crawling around and eating until it gets plump and fat. It then finds a safe place to wrap itself in a silk cocoon. During this phase, the caterpillar completely rearranges his body, turning to goo and shedding his face until he hatches into this.
Butterflies and moths.
An adult moth. It flies around sipping nectar and helps to pollinate, much like the bee. It then uses this energy to mate and die. It gets one shot, as most of them only live a few weeks. I hope it can set a living example that even when we've exhausted one life, we can always change to live another.
That's my boy.
It's beautiful. Where did you get the idea for the wings?
It came on the wind, I suppose. They come in a variety of styles. In fact, some develop a chrysalis and become butterflies, which have long proboscises and shinier wings.
Truly beautiful.
What is the point of these? We already have bees to pollinate flowers.
I want them to exist.
That's not good enough. We can't devote resources to something just because you want it to happen.
Empyrean said that...
Empyrean is an airhead.
My head is indeed full of air. So are we all full of air.
Isn't it enough that they're beautiful?
Oh, creating something beautiful for beauty's sake. You're delusional.
Don't take it personally, kid. I don't think that we're interested in ideas from lower level angels this close to the big day.
Ariel?
While we do enjoy your ideas, small one, we cannot justify the creation of these species when you lack the proper instruction we archangels have on managing and designing the world of beasts. There are careful things to consider, such as the beast's impact on the food chain, the environment, and whether it will have a place in the world once humans lay claim to creation.
Why do you insist on wasting our time with more bugs?
I don't know. I love them. They're a part of me.
Oh, stop being emotional.
What am I supposed to be? When you attack my insects, you attack me. I am what I create. Don't you get it? I am the little ant trying to slip into creation amongst the leviathans, the behemoths, and
Z's.
We think you should leave, small one.
Good luck fixing the food chain.
Actually, now that you're not there to distract her, Arachne has finally fixed the food chain.
Oh. Arachne didn't tell you.
What didn't Arachne tell me?
Well, with your archangel status and fancy training, I thought you'd all see this coming. The food chain has a huge hole in it, and all species will die out in a month if we don't take extreme action.
Terriel, is this true?
Ugh, he's desperate. He's lying.
Wow, Terriel, now two of your employees are slipping up under your management?
I just told you that he's lying. Arachne!
Arachne enters.
You summoned me?
Is what I'm hearing about the food chain true?
What are you hearing about
the food chain? It's going to collapse upon creation!
What? Ariel, nice to meet all of you.
Is the food chain ready for the fifth day, or did you lie to Terriel?
Enti, did you tell?
Why didn't you tell them?
The situation is far worse than our previous projections.
We are not pleased, Terriel.
Oh, to think after Entiel's breach of etiquette, you would somehow find a way to surpass him in incompetence. Get out of my sight. You're fired, effective immediately.
Terriel, don't.
Oh, you stop talking.
Wait a minute. Is she not the one who discovered the problem in the first place?
We agree. Terriel, you cannot fire every angel who angers you for doing their job well. We may need to conduct a performance review of your work as a manager.
There's no need for all of that. I'm working on a solution, I swear. I was going to tell you after I finished my design, but I have a creature that could help fix the food chain.
But we already have one, don't we?
And what would that be, enlightened one?
Bugs.
No one was talking to you.
You're going to have to. You always told me the world didn't need insects, but now I know that the world needs insects more than it needs fish or mammals or even birds. Without bugs, anything you three have ever made will die.
There is no way those tiny, gross, crawling, creeping things are the solution that will save all of creation.
Seeing as you failed to recognize the problem, despite your own ecosystem engineer discovering it, I don't think you necessarily have four legs to stand on, furry or otherwise.
We should invite Terriel's team in on meetings more often.
Why don't we invite your team to meetings too?
That won't be necessary because, unlike you, I have a grasp of what's going on.
Entiel, how many insects have you drafted?
I had a couple thousand as of this morning, but after my breakthrough with moths and butterflies, I explored cicadas and then mantises and then went back to beetles. I lost track around 200,000.
There must be a solution in there somewhere.
Surely we're not about to go over thousands of different bugs.
You have the floor, small one. Arachne, you're dismissed.
Oh, yes, I'll go back to work.
She shoots a sad look at Entiel and exits.
Thank you. I want to start with the alderfly.
End of day. We will now take a 10-minute intermission. Thank you.
What's for dinner?
They'll never stop asking. With so much cooking, it's a good thing there's BJ's Wholesale Club with up to 25% off grocery store prices. And that's before coupons. Order online and get same-day grocery delivery. Not a member? Join BJ's Wholesale Club at bjs.com/membership today.
I'm not supposed to be here. Can you help me get back?
Here we go again.
You're missing out on the joys of life like pizza.
You can't fight.
No taste.
They're following you. Your cravings for nacho fries will never stop. The warm nacho cheese sauce and savory Mexican spices will not let you get away. So there's only one thing left to do. Run to Taco Bell, because nacho fries are back. Head to Taco Bell and silence your cravings before nacho fries disappear again. Only at Taco Bell. At participating U.S. locations for a limited time only.
Any credit card can offer cash back, but only Discover matches all the cash back you've earned at the end of your first year. It's like getting one of those birthday cards that's shaped like cash, so you already know there's cash inside before opening it. But in this case, it's stuffed with your first year cash back match, and you don't even have to send a thank you note. Cashback match. Only by Discover Card. Learn more at discover.com/match. Discover. Something brighter.
Oh,
Day 4. Marina's office. She talks on the phone.
The fact of the matter is, I am still up to my ears in sharks, drowning in eels, and I don't know if I want to go forward with the Sela camp. No, I am not giving it to Triton. I don't want to give it to Triton because he messed up the salmon migratory patterns. They were never supposed to go that far upstream. Yeah, well, I told him that, but he did it anyway. All this is to say, I need you to reschedule the meeting with the bug boy. I don't have anything prepared yet. Yes, I know that he's presenting to me, but I just need you to move my meeting with
Entiel. Enters. Entiel.
How are you, sweetie? Give me 1 second. Calypso. Yeah, he just walked in. I know you didn't know, because if you knew, you would have told me, right? Yes, I know. Yes, this will all be easier when time is formalized. I'm not mad at you. I'll talk to you Lake Baikal. Crap, I forgot about Lake Baikal. Okay. Nope, I'll handle it. Bye.
Entiel is looking up.
Hey, thanks for waiting. Hello?
Have you seen it yet?
What, the sun?
It's stunning.
The earlier designs were better.
You don't like it?
Doesn't matter if I like it or not, but I hate it. Between you and me, the beta version was better. Sit.
He sits.
So,
I'll pause you right there. I've been looking over the food chain for the lakes, rivers, and seas, and I don't believe that we have any issues. So thank you for coming, but I'll get you on your way to Terriel to deal with that mess.
But Ariel said I was to meet with all of you to design insects for all three domains.
Mm-hmm. But fortunately for both of us, I don't have a need for insects.
But the memo from the last meeting
is out of date.
May I see the updated projections?
That's for archangels only.
So when I tell Ariel you don't see a need for insects despite their direct orders to the contrary, you'll present them with your new findings.
Fine. I'm developing my own workaround. I simply haven't had time to flesh it out yet.
Listen, I understand if you don't like them.
Don't like them? They're brilliant. What, you think that I'm grossed out by their tiny size or their compound eyes or whatever? The oceans aren't just clownfish and coral reefs. I designed the sea cucumber, for Christ's sake.
For Christ's sake?
No, he didn't specifically request. Stick with me. I've made fish that have transparent skulls with eyes that gaze out from inside of their bodies. I gave eels a second set of jaws so that they could lock down with one set and chew with the other. Jellyfish live without brains. I made tentacles. There is some weird shit I'm putting in the water, and let me tell you a little secret. I designed all of it. My team has been working around the clock, putting together ecosystems to cover 70% of the Earth's surface, but every single species is 100% me. Do you understand what I'm getting at? This project is my baby, and you think I'm supposed to just let you barge in here with a million new species at the 11th hour? It's not happening.
Have you always had this kind of creative freedom?
Actually, no. You do know I used to work alongside Terriel.
They never mentioned it.
Of course they didn't. The department used to be a lot smaller. Empyrean was in and out, but Terriel and I drafted all the early ideas for life forms. In the beginning, everything we did was aquatic. We went through a lot of single-celled organisms, and then those evolved, and before we knew it, we were in the Cambrian explosion, but trilobites and ammonites were a trial run to get our feet wet. I got promoted to department head, and Ter got to start his own department. That's when you were hired.
I would never be able to tell.
I know. Ter was always an ass, but eventually they stopped having fun with the job.
Them? Have fun?
This job gets to you after a while. What I would give to discover fish again and just create one thing after another.
Is that not what you do?
It just stops being fun when you have 7 different projects to juggle at once and deadlines and admin duties to attend to. And you'll see.
Don't you have a whole team?
Don't get me started. They're like herding catfish.
Nobody on your team has ever had an idea for something they'd like to see in the water.
I mean, yeah, but none of them were good enough.
You're more like Terriel than you realize.
No. They're stubborn and rude and jaded and shit.
You need to learn to share. You have so much on your plate and you have a team for a reason.
But it's my creative process. You know how personal that is.
You realize the only reason I'm here right now is because Empyrean saw my ideas and gave me the opportunity to explore them. Z wanted to share Xerspace with me. Empyrean isn't vainly holding on to this idea that the sky is Xer's. And as much as I understand being proud of your worth, your work, what worth is it when it blocks out angels who may have fresh ideas that need to be heard? Because if I was never heard, we'd be creating a world right now that could never survive. Don't you want to give Calypso the opportunity to discover what fish did for you or what insects have done for me?
You're getting awfully high and mighty. Are you sure you aren't an archangel?
I know I'm not.
What insects do you have for the ocean?
They're called crustaceans. They have the same hard exoskeleton as insects and similar antennae and structure.
Oh no, these are good.
Better than your workaround?
I was just going to make like a giant squid, so yeah. Let's see, shrimp, crabs, hello, Mr. Isopod.
I'm pretty proud of that one.
Entiel, you should give yourself more credit. You're not here because Empyrean chose you. You're here because you're talented.
No, I'm here because I care about the work. I have to go see you-know-who.
Good luck. Tell Tara I love them.
Actually, before I go, you mentioned I'll eventually see how it stops being fun after a while. Is that true? Will I lose my passion for what I'm doing?
Yes.
NTL exits. Marina thinks, dials a phone.
Hey, Calypso. Yeah, I'm good. I actually wanted to ask you, what was that animal you proposed? I didn't like the name. Right, the sea horse. I wanted to revisit it. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Actually, I want to have a last minute meeting with the whole team. I am going to delegate the whole of Lake Baikal project so that I can focus on whales. Yes, it will end up having a very unique ecosystem. I will just have to deal. Awesome. All right. See you in a bit. Bye.
Terriel's office. Terriel and Arachne.
Arachne, Entiel should be on his way. Before he gets here, I want you to know that I am very aware that the situation has changed far beyond anything we could have foreseen. Your discovery of the break in the food chain, along with Entiel's bugs, may have saved us all. However, there is still work to be done filling the gaps and fixing the ecosystem. The fate of creation is bigger than you or me or any bad blood between us.
I also wanted to apologize.
That being said, you're still not off the hook.
Oh.
Were you expecting an apology?
Entiel enters.
Hi, everyone.
We will continue this conversation later.
I'm sorry, I can come back.
No, you're here. Let's get to work.
Right.
Arachne.
What?
You had something you wanted to present.
Oh, right. I did. Just let me get my notes.
You're going to present something?
Arachne came to me with a creature that I think could truly benefit creation.
She did?
She did.
And you like it?
Is that so hard to believe?
Okay, I'm ready.
Let's hear it.
I'm sorry. This isn't how I wanted to do this, so I don't think I can.
You can do it. I want to know all about what you've come up with.
Don't. I am mad at you.
What?
Arachne is mad because...
I'm mad at you too, and you're both mad at each other.
I'm not mad.
Bullshit.
We are angels. We don't feel things.
Then why are you mad at me?
I'm not mad. I'm just acting out of principle. Can you just present the spider?
Now you gave away what it's called.
A spider? I want to know about that.
Oh, do not lie. You are just trying to escape your discomfort with the situation.
I am uncomfortable.
Why did you tell on me?
The food chain collapsing shouldn't have been a secret.
Oh, so now my secrets aren't worth keeping.
That isn't a secret to keep. And when did you swear me to secrecy?
You're both being hysterical. Let's all just take an hour and we'll come back to this later.
We are going to stay here and talk about our feelings until we feel better.
You can't physically make us stay here and talk about our feelings.
I am going to take this yarn and wrap it around us so we can't go anywhere until I stop wanting to cry.
And how do you plan to manage that?
I already have.
Entiel and Terriel are trapped in a web.
Oh God, she's gone mad.
Yes. Terriel, how do you feel?
This is stupid.
No, you have to use I feel statements.
I feel this is stupid.
We'll come back to you. Entiel, how do you feel?
If I'm being perfectly honest, I feel afraid.
Good. Why?
I'm afraid that you don't want to be my friend anymore.
That's very good. Terriel, you could learn a thing or two from Entiel.
I wish I wasn't immortal so you could kill me.
Enti, I came to you with my discovery because I didn't know what to do. And you dismissed me. Sorry. I feel that you dismissed me. And then when you saw the food chain as an opportunity to push for your insects, you went for it. even though you knew I'd get punished.
I was hurt because I had just been fired and was kind of going through my own personal crisis. I didn't know how to be there for you when you needed me. But I had no idea you hadn't told Terriel about the food chain problem. I saw my insects as a solution to a very serious issue. I'm sorry I hurt you.
And I'm sorry too. Your dreams are coming true and I can't be there to celebrate with you.
You're my best friend.
And you're mine.
They cry and hug.
Can I get out now?
Oh, Terry, I'm sorry. Do you want a hug too?
I can't say I'm in the market for more things to wrap around my body.
Do you feel like your feelings have been heard?
I think I've made myself perfectly clear.
I'm glad.
She lets them both out.
So,
what is a spider?
It's my creature. You're going to love it. I was inspired by God, but I was also inspired by you because I was so mad at you that I decided to make something that lives by eating insects and other bugs. To spite you. So I made this.
Ah!
It's cute, right? It's furry, and instead of those big eyes, I gave it several cute smaller ones. It makes webs out of this really incredible silk. It's like the silk you made, but better. And it has eight legs, because eight is better than six. And it has two body segments, because two is better than three. Insects fly into its web, and they get stuck. And then it wraps them up like a cozy blanket, and it drains them of their insides. Are you okay? You look pale.
Oh, I'm fine.
Oh, you hate it.
Oh, no. It's brilliant. I'm so proud of you.
We believe the spider could be a real asset to balancing out the food chain. It helps fill in a gap between many bugs and larger predators.
You're shaking, Enti.
Oh, out of excitement.
You are not a good liar, even for an angel.
It's terrifying. I've never seen anything that struck more fear in me. I'm sorry. I really want to like it, and I understand its purpose, but I just can't look at it without wanting to set myself on fire.
Is it because it eats your bugs? Well, don't worry. Some of them eat lizards and birds.
And some of them live in burrows underground, which I think is a nice touch. Imagine spiders covering the earth.
I'd rather not.
Well, I can see my ideas are a little too brilliant for you, so I will hold off on scorpions for now.
Oh, why? I'm finally having fun.
Actually, why don't we shift over to why I'm here and address how we're going to incorporate insects into the beasts of the land?
Well, we already have a lot of your older drafts that we are going to fold into the arachnid designs. Since Ariel has willed it, I don't have a problem with silverfish, walking sticks, or even centipedes.
Where are we at with the soil issue?
We met with the grotesque gardeners in the plant department, and surprise, surprise, they didn't offer too many solutions. They were able to tweak ferns and mosses, but it was too late to do any major edits to the root systems for flowering plants, which is a problem because most animals will need those to survive, including humans and humans.
They actually weren't able to change the designs for those plants because it would have interfered with the bumblebee.
Oh, which reminds me, they did go ahead and design a whole subsection of plants specifically designed to eat bugs.
Are you serious? Those angels over in horticulture are some real assholes.
Hey, don't speak ill of the asshole. That is my greatest invention.
I thought Marina invented the anus.
The only thing Marina invented was plagiarism.
That's it.
He furiously draws in his notebook and sketches, then shows the result.
Anuses.
That is a squiggle.
I think the pressure's finally gotten to him.
No, it's actually the most simple and effective solution. I would like to present you both with the worm.
That is certainly not an insect.
Not at all. But it has the spirit of a bug. You said yourself that animal feces could reintroduce nutrients to the soil. These would burrow through the earth, aerating the soil and depositing their moist feces along the way. They're small enough to get through root systems without disturbing them. And I mean, they could be key to the facilitating decomposition.
So they're just moving anuses.
I think it's their simplicity that makes them so powerful.
Entiel, you've done it again. I'm impressed. You have presented something so low, so foul, that it is a complete affront to me and to God, frankly.
Why are you like this?
Because I take my job seriously.
Sorry, I didn't just throw together four legs and some fur and call it a day.
Oh, would that be so bad? To do things the way I asked you to.
The way you do things doesn't work. It hasn't worked since you got this position. You used to have fun making things, and now it's all right and wrong, black and white with you.
Do not confuse naivete for creativity, you slow-witted worm.
I feel like we should stick to more neutral statements.
You are the least creative angel working on creation. You constantly dismiss me, and now that we're on equal footing, you still dismiss me.
We are not on equal footing. You think because Ariel has decided we need your input that you can talk to an archangel this way.
Oh, screw the archangels! You make some terrible bosses! I love Zer to death, but even Empyrean is hard to work with at times.
Blasphemy!
Tell him, Arachne.
Terry, you do tend to be rather rigid and unforgiving.
That's my managerial style.
Well, it can come off sometimes as kind of maybe...
authoritarian?
I was going to say utterly soul-crushing, but I mean, same difference.
Oh, clearly you two have been discussing this behind my back for some time. I'm going to leave. There is no use staying where I am not respected. I will see you at our meeting, NT.
They exit.
Oh, I feel dirty.
They speak of respect as if it's something to be freely given by those beneath them.
You're making me uncomfortable.
God forbid.
That's right. They do forbid it.
You know the worst part? They're right. The more I think about it, the more stupid the worm seems. It's just a line with a mouth and a butthole.
And so what if it is?
It doesn't feel like something I'd make. It feels uninspired.
Does it do what it needs to do?
I mean, yes.
Then it's perfect. One day, a young Duman will discover a worm in the garden, and he'll watch it squirm around in his dirt-covered hands, fascinated by a line with a mouth and a butthole. And they'll love it. And they'll bring it in to show their mother, who will probably scold them and tell them to put it back in the earth where it belongs, because the worm belongs in the earth. And then the Duman will go inside because it's late and their mother is making human for dinner. Besides, you weren't completely uninspired. You had the anus.
I went from completely overflowing with ideas I never thought would see the light of day to scrounging around for worms. I thought if I had more creative freedom, making creatures would be so much easier, but it's so much more exhausting.
Why don't we go look at the sky? Clear your head.
I already saw it. The sun is great, but apparently the beta was better.
Oh, but Enti, it's nighttime now.
He looks up. Stars and the moon.
Oh. Is that what the stars look like?
They're beautiful.
They're also small up there.
Just like bugs.
I think they've given me an idea.
Of course they have. What is it?
A little beetle that lights up. And in the summer, they'll fly at night. In such numbers, all the earth will reflect the starlit sky. And children will try to catch them. So they don't need to merely gaze upon the stars. They can chase them too.
Why do you think we're going through all the trouble of making creation?
All of us? I can't ever say I questioned it.
Half the time, I think it's for our benefit.
For our benefit?
After the war and Lucifer fell, I think God saw us angels all torn apart and sad. We lost our... God wasn't the only one who was betrayed. We all were. We lost our siblings and we had to cast the mid in the pit ourselves. How were we supposed to deal with that? And God saw that it was bad. So they decided that we were to assist and participate in creation. And through it, we have finally been able to dream of a new world. We could make something fruitful and vibrant in the wake of all that loss.
That's why God is doing all this?
Well, they are not very good at returning my phone calls, but I'd like to think that I am good at reading these sorts of things.
I really do think the spider is good. It's way better than the worm.
Well, I know it is. Thank you. But you don't need to disparage the worm. You made it. It's brilliant. You may not feel like it right now, but you are a huge inspiration to me. I never would have thought of the spider if you hadn't encouraged me. So if you feel stuck with your creative work, then maybe I can be an encouragement to you.
I could use that.
You better get to your meeting. It's late.
Oh, right. Thanks. And thank you, Arachne.
He exits. As she sits under the stars, her web connects together the constellations.
Much better.
The conference room. Ariel, Terriel, Marina, Empyrean. Entiel enters and sits.
You are late.
I was catching up with a friend.
Friend. The crazy ideas lower-level angels come up with. We begin. Today is the fourth day. The sun, moon, and stars have been created, and God has seen that they are good in record time. Tomorrow is the day you have all been preparing for. Marina, we begin with you.
Things are going swimmingly. Whales are locked, loaded, and ready to go. We were able to push their size beyond any of our previous projections. We originally thought that whales would cap out at about 40 feet, long, but we managed to double that. Leviathans will rule the deep, and I want to thank you all for letting me spearhead this. Whales might be my magnum opus.
And you work with Entiel?
Yes, he gave me a slew of underwater arthropods. It really inspired my team, so on top of crustaceans, we, mostly they, came up with more bottom feeders to keep the oceans clean. And they came up with such good ideas. We now have starfish, sponges, and Terriel. You'll love this one. The seahorse.
I love the work your team has done.
Thank you, Entiel. You provided me, all of us, a fresh perspective that we needed.
You never fail to disappoint. Empyrean.
Been down in the dumps since Entiel got famous and flew the coop. Oh, he stayed in all day. I'm gonna play down for a bit. And came up with this.
A bat.
I'm very excited for my goth phase.
Is that all?
Wow, the skies are flying so high. There'll be everything we need. A feather in a hat. You'll be macaroni.
If you were a higher ranking angel, we would be in trouble. Terriel?
We've incorporated most of Entiel's old insect ideas, and we have made this.
A spider.
Please warn me.
No.
And the soil issue?
We were unable to come up with an idea.
Actually, I
am... Oh, don't.
Oh, I came up with something.
It's not worth our time.
It's called the worm.
It's in.
What? It looked like that. It's this base crawling, creeping thing. You don't even ask for an explanation of what it does.
It's in.
Oh, he just drew a line with a butthole.
Not a cloaca?
It's too simple to have a cloaca.
Ariel, I have never been so insulted in my life. And I have suffered many insults in these meetings.
We merely channel the will of creation.
How? When I was grilled for eons about the horse, was that the will of creation? When my Yeti was rejected, but Marina's Loch Ness monster got in no problem, how was that a fair judgment from higher up?
You dare challenge us?
Marina gets everything she wants. She has created creatures for the seas that I could never get away with. It's not fair that she gets mollusks and cephalopods, and I couldn't get a single dinosaur into creation.
Everyone feels vaguely guilty.
Do you remember that, Entiel? I used to be passionate about the creatures I was making. Just like you. But mine weren't small, creeping things. They were big, proud, strong beasts that would tower over all creation. They were my whale. They were my magnum opus. But then you, Ariel, you came and shot them all down, and I was forced to start all over again. So what if mammals and reptiles get repetitive? How can you look at the strength of the tiger or the might of the elephant and not feel inspired? Am I not talented? I have made peace with the end of the dinosaurs, but then this small angel comes in with disgusting, strange creatures, and you let them into creation like it's nothing. It's not fair, Ariel. Why do these three all get whatever they want when I can't even get a unicorn?
Are you done?
I invoke copyright.
Are you crazy? That actually invokes copyright.
certainly was a surprise to me.
Tomorrow, the beasts of the earth are to be made, but I refuse to let a single one step on foot on earth until someone gives me and my horses the time of day.
Oh, I can give you the time of day. It's dawn.
The sun rises.
Oh, today is the big day.
Day 5, continuous with the previous scene.
We know not why God created copyright. Marina, Empyrean, Entiel, go. Creation is waiting. We shall discuss matters with Terriel.
Are the sun and the moon supposed to move that quickly?
I am pleased that time flies as swift as my birds. Entiel?
Yes?
Are you coming?
To Earth?
Of course.
We finally get to see our creatures be created for real.
Before day's end, you'll be able to hold your insects in your hands and see your creations realized.
I can't.
Why not?
I invoke copyright.
Are you insane?
Does copyright even apply to lower angels?
Copyright is a sacred force that even God themselves cannot oppose. The highest angel would be thrown into the lowest pit of hell if they were to break it, or worse, legislate it. It protects all angels, demons, humans, and even dolphins.
Oh, sweet.
I know creation needs my creatures more than most, so I will withhold them until Terriel is heard. Because I know all too well what it's like to have your ideas dismissed.
Suit yourself. Good luck, Antiel. And Ter, I hope you get what you need.
I love you.
Oh, Empyrean, will you stay and help us?
No!
Marina and Empyrean exit.
I don't want your help.
I figured as much, but here I am.
Ariel, I will not allow worms in the earth unless I get some of my previously rejected creatures back into creation.
Worms are not yours to withhold.
Terriel has my full support. All the leverage my bugs have to offer is theirs.
Ariel, do you know what I want?
We cannot put dinosaurs into creation. They would wreck the ecosystem.
We recognize copyright, but that doesn't mean we must bow to every demand of your petty tantrum.
I know, I understand. You know what I really want, though? Mother fucking horses!
No!
Yes, equines the world over! I want striped horses.
A zebra.
I want small horses.
A pony.
I want frumpy horses.
A donkey.
We cannot allow this.
Can you allow the world to be made without berries, nuts, fruits, and vegetables?
No, so many would starve.
Then it sure would be a huge bummer if we went through all the trouble of designing bees just to create a world without them.
Very well. All Save of your bees, horse wishes will be realized, except unicorns. Are you finished?
Not quite. I want to make something weird that gets into creation. No strings attached.
What kind of nonsense request is that?
Remember how my insects are the base of the entire food chain?
Proceed.
All right. Webbed feet, duck bill, a beaver tail. It's a mammal, but it lays eggs. Oh, and fuck it, it's venomous.
The platypus.
It's an abomination.
This might easily be my favorite thing you've ever made, Terbear.
Oh, Entiel, please. Call me Terriel.
Are you quite pleased?
Not yet. Remember dogs?
Absolutely not. They are weak, deluded wolves.
And they're getting into creation, or else you lose all your apex predators.
You wouldn't.
You put dogs in, or I take lions out.
Very well. Dogs are welcome into creation. We cannot fathom what anyone would want with them, but we digress.
Oh, one last thing, I swear.
It had better be the last, or I will gladly let creation fail and throw you both in the pit for your insolence.
You pass along every single creature in Entiel's notebook.
What?
Do you think me incapable of a change of heart? I recognize when someone has done me a favor.
Terriel passes Entiel's notebook along. Ariel does not open the book.
Very well. We will allow all the sketches in this notebook into creation.
It's been a pleasure. We are done. It's been a pleasure.
Ariel exits.
You didn't have to.
They didn't even open it. How many species did you have in there? No, I don't want to know. You know what I've learned, Entiel? Nothing matters. We are so hyped up on what works and what doesn't, we forget to let go and just create. Ariel would never have allowed horses or dogs or the platypus. They would have told me it was ludicrous or unnecessary, but people wouldn't get it. And I took that as fact for so long. I assumed I knew how the rules worked. And you came along with hundreds and thousands of bugs. Oh, they are the most bizarre little things that I have ever seen. They are ugly, just truly and utterly ugly and unsettling, revolting. I can't stomach them.
I get it.
Since day zero, I told you how I felt about them, and yet you just kept making them, even after I told you not to. And apparently, they work. I was wrong. Ariel acts all self-important, like they channel God directly. It's bullshit. They're as impulsive and selfish as the rest of us. They have four faces. Who knows which one is at the wheel at any given time? Nothing matters! I'm so glad I fired you.
Me too.
Well, I suppose we changed the course of creation. The fifth day is done.
The sun sets.
That is very fast. I hope they fix that.
The beasts of the earth and your stuff.
The creeping things.
And on the sixth day, God will make the beasts of the earth and cattle and every creeping thing, all according to their various kinds, alongside the humans.
And on the seventh day, the Dumans.
Oh, I can't wait to take a vacation after all of this. I'm going to go to the spa on Venus and soak myself in tar so thick my physical form will fossilize. Fossils.
Is something funny?
Nothing matters! I'll see you tomorrow, Entiel.
They exit. Entiel stares at the stars for a while.
I think it matters. It has to, right? What we're doing means something. It has a purpose. God, your taste in silence is impeccable. Just letting the big questions hang out there. Okay, I'm leaving now. I have a big day tomorrow. You know, I think when I call out into the universe, I'd rather hear something back. Like the screaming of cicadas or the chirping of crickets. And at least lets me know I'm not alone. I'd rather the background of the cosmos be white noise and a complete void. You can't extrapolate something out of nothing. Oh. But that's exactly what we've been doing this whole time. I get it. I don't. I just like sketching bugs. All right. See you tomorrow, I guess.
He exits. Day 6. Terriel and Ariel. They stand in a place not unlike Empyrean's blank studio, but still distinct from it. They look out at something.
Did yesterday go well after our meeting?
It did. The great whales, beasts of the sea, and all the fowl of the air were created. God saw everything was good.
And mine, Entiel's absence?
God didn't seem to bring it up. We hope you didn't miss your window.
Oh, consequences to our actions. I didn't know you had a sense of humor, Ariel.
You know full well the consequences when an angel fails.
Don't be ridiculous. We only get punished for rebelling.
We fail to see the difference.
Entiel enters, gazes out at what Ariel and Terriel have been looking at.
There he is, the angel of the hour.
That tiny thing over there is creation?
Yes.
The Earth?
We are to stay here as God creates all the creatures we have agreed to. Afterwards, we may go down to observe the fruit of our labor.
Why can't we be down there?
It is dangerous. Any angel found on Earth while God installs updates may find themselves encrypted into the fabric of space-time and never be seen again.
So we just wait?
It won't be long. In fact, beasts of the earth and the creeping things will be created in 3, 2...
Blackout. Then come up a stark, unnatural blue.
The blue sky of death.
You!
Me?
You have tricked us! You have tricked God!
I didn't trick anybody.
How many species were in that notebook?
Oh, I'm not sure. A million?
You have overwhelmed creation. It has crashed the system.
I didn't know. I didn't mean to. Terriel!
Oh, don't pull me into this.
You gave them my notebook. And you didn't so much as read it. How was this my fault?
Terriel!
Don't you realize? None of this matters. What is creation? The Earth? I mean, who gives a shit?
God gives a shit.
What are you gonna do? Throw me into the pit? We're both archangels. Besides, the higher-ups will want someone to be punished, and it doesn't have to be you or me. I happen to have the perfect fall guy. Bugs crashed creation, and Entiel made bugs.
I didn't want to crash creation. I didn't mean for my whole notebook to get made. I didn't know I drew so many arthropods. I just like to draw bugs.
You are to be punished, Entiel.
A pit to have appears. Instead of the typical fire and brimstone, it's metal and flashing with electricity rather like a bug zapper.
Please tell me, if I get thrown into hell, do my bugs still get made?
What does it matter?
If I get sent to hell, do insects stay in creation?
There are no longer any plans for a world without insects. The world cannot exist without them.
Then throw me in.
You damned fool.
Entiel is about to enter the pit when Empyrean walks in.
Entiel, enough! Ariel, fuck off!
Empyrean, you bad-brained idiot! Do you wish to join your precious people in hell?
What?
Empyrean, go away. This doesn't concern you.
Oh, I see. I didn't change my form.
With a crack of lightning, Empyrean transforms into a mighty seraph with multiple pairs of flaming wings. The pit closes up.
Are you kidding me? You've been a seraph this whole time? The highest order of angel? What?
And you've been the very asshole you invented this whole time. Now, as I said earlier, Ariel, fuck off!
But what of creation?
Oh my god, it's fine. Look.
The blue lights go down and we return to normal.
God just didn't have the room at first, so they rebooted.
They didn't have to go through all that trouble for my bugs.
Entiel, love you so much. God wanted them. However, creating millions more species than originally intended did push both God and creation to the limit.
Millions?
Yes.
Of insects?
And there wouldn't have been half that many bugs if you didn't insist on Entiel's whole notebook going into production.
What of the humans and the Doomans?
The Dooman race has been officially scrapped for further development. Humans are to inherit the Earth now.
You changed creation?
Oh, don't you talk to my protege like that. Change begets creation. So too does creation beget change. Creation transforms us and the world around us in tandem. Try to keep up with the art as it happens, Ariel. I can't say too much, but we are developing a forbidden fruit to grant Dooman qualities to human beings.
Was this all part of some greater plan? Was it always supposed to be this way?
No! God has no idea what they're doing. Neither do I. That's the fun of it. Maybe humans will eat of the fruit before it's ready. Ooh, forced to walk a path between human and Dooman for all eternity. All art is an improv. Because so is life.
Doesn't matter after all.
It all matters, Terriel. You really need to learn to listen.
Listen to what?
You're so silly. Oh. I'll tell you a secret. All of my birds, they have a lot of dinosaur in them. Open your eyes, and maybe then you can see your true, beautiful impact on the world. I love you. Now go away, you two. My poor baby Entiel is scarred.
Ariel exits as Terriel turns to say something.
The Earth is up and running. You've been working toward this for longer than I have. Go figure out what it was all for. And thank you for making sure my bugs would be the most populous species on this planet.
Terriel exits.
Isn't that fun?
You were a seraph the whole time?
Yeah, I thought it was pretty obvious.
My bugs really changed the course of creation?
Heaven is all abuzz with the gossip. little angel changed the world before it even started. And between you and me, God is so exhausted from readjusting around everything around your bugs that they might just take this stuff as like a self-care sort of day.
God gets tired?
Ugh, I am. Aren't you?
I'm not. I almost got thrown into hell just now, so I'm a bit electrified.
You are crazy. Oh, I love that.
Empyrean, can I ask you a question?
No. Oh my God, I'm just kidding. I'm kidding. What's up?
Why did we do all of this? Why did we make the world? Why did I?
You know why.
I do.
You don't?
I don't think so.
Well, that's your first problem.
What is?
I would love to do this, like, till the sun explodes. But I actually have official business I need to take care of.
You do?
I do.
What is it?
It?
Oh, you're doing it again.
I can't help it. You're so cute.
The official business.
I came here to let you know that you are to be promoted.
What?
I'm making you an Archangel, Entiel.
Empyrean presents and dons Entiel in beetle armor.
What is this?
Your armor. Every creeping thing that crawls upon the earth is under your protection. You are the archangel of all insects, crustaceans, myriapods, and worms.
I am?
You are.
Already?
Just happened.
And that's it.
It's very underwhelming. Turns out angel ranks are fake. Like gender or money.
What's money?
Exactly.
Empyrean.
My name.
My bugs are down there right now.
Are?
Can I go see them?
Oh, I thought you were too afraid to ask.
I almost was.
Oh.
Entiel runs off.
I really didn't have the heart to question him about mosquitoes. Like... Why? I love you, but like, why?
Empyrean exits. The earth. The wind blows. The sun shines. Sounds of life teem throughout the planet. Antoinette enters, astounded with everything he sees. He suddenly stops and focuses as a butterfly flies toward him. First bug. He reaches out a hand and it lands there. He looks at it and smiles as it crawls on his fingers and flips on top of his head. Then it flies away. Just as it leaves our vision, he gasps.
That's why.
End of play.